In between the release of Sonic 06 and Shadow the Hedgehog, Sega released a game called Sonic Riders in 2006. This game is a hoverboard racing game which features lots of action and hoverboards, of course, along with fast-paced gameplay. The only problem is the gameplay utterly fails. So anyways, let's take a look at this game, shall we? The first thing you see when you start the game up is this cool anime cutscene. Sadly, it seems like a lot of the budget went towards this and not the actual gameplay. Then again, it's Sega after all, and they haven't made a good racing game since, like, Outrun 2, maybe. Well, there have been a few exceptions, but the arcades are dead, and sadly, it seems Sega has not made as many good racing games as they used to. Now on the actual gameplay, of course, since everyone wants me. The plot of it is still garbage, because, you know, it's a Sonic game. This time, the plot is something about Eggman running some hoverboard racing competition, and he wants everyone to give a chaos emerald to enter, and the winner takes all, except here's the thing. The winner is actually them, some Babylonian robes or some crap. This is also the first CGI cutscene I've ever seen in a Sonic game, where they actually talk with the middle of their mouths and not the sideways like in Sonic Heroes. The cutscenes are also high budget for the CGI, too. I'm honestly wondering why they didn't just, you know, make more cutscenes in CGI, unless their budget was still really tiny. It still does not excuse the lack of plot, though. Sega has also finally learned how to make an in-game cutscene that actually looks like a good cutscene. Maybe they actually have a higher budget and enough time to actually make them look like cutscenes. Why didn't they do that with their other Sonic games? I mean, come on, imagine if Sonic Adventure 1 had this cutscene instead of just... Remember Sonic Adventure 1? Congratulations, Sega. You've actually managed to make a decent-looking cutscene on outdated hardware. Congratulations. You win. It took about, what, 8 years to get that right? But hey, at least you did it. Better late than ever, I guess. So anyways, on to the gameplay. The graphics are great in this game, too, and so is the music. I mean, come on, you expected the music to be good, but the graphics are actually a surprise considering that most Sonic games on the PS2 run at an inconsistent frame rate about 5 FPS, for example, Shadow the Hedgehog, but the only problem with the game is the gameplay. The gameplay is bad. The gameplay feels like there are a whole bunch of concepts, but they haven't been polished very much. For example, the sun system. The sun system is pretty good, but when you spin the stick, there's only so much you can do by spinning the stick. Then again, it's a racing game, but there are other problems, too, such as the boost and pit stop system, which is an exact ripoff of that from F-Zero. Unlike F-Zero, instead of where you just go on the side track to regenerate, in this game, what happens is you end up getting it through doing tricks or collecting object blocks that replenish it. And if you run out, you'll have to walk until you can find a pit stop. Imagine how you play a racing game in the middle and you stop for a pit stop. It's pretty bad. There are also certain power-ups you can collect that make you, say, run over enemies, for example. The gameplay wouldn't be so bad had the controls not been absolutely horrible. The controls pretty much break the entire game. So even if the gameplay is just okay, the controls make it even worse because you'll be slip-sliding all around the place due to the controls of the game. You'll be bouncing and moving around for no reason, and when you try to do stuff, you'll just be like, why isn't this working? But, what the heck, this isn't the worst part of the game. The level designs are pretty bad too. For layer levels, the corners are hard to make, and there are lots of death hits too with respawning, so it's pretty hard, especially when you're trying to do the levels. The AI in the level is pretty stupid too, so you can always come in first when you know how to do it well, so it really isn't much of a challenge. Sure, you can unlock more courses, but why can't we have them unlocked because of the multiplayer mode? The game also contains a multiplayer mode, but, and it actually supports the multitasker ones, but if you have friends over, you might not want to play with them. If you have a multitasker, you'll probably have a lot better games to be playing too. I mean, there are plenty of quick-screen shooter games on the PC, you can be playing one of those. Aside from the gameplay, the game has also had a few other mild technical issues and features we wish were implemented, such as there's no online multiplayer at any of the versions. I mean, I know it's one thing on the GameCube or another game's online, but the Xbox and PS2 have online system, like, why is this the multiplayer on those? The game might be a lot more replayable then. There are also slight technical issues, such as pop-in, and there's very slight slowdown. There's not very much slowdown, luckily, but there is a tiny amount. All in all, the game isn't that great. I mean, this game could have been a lot better, but sadly, the four controls killed it. Now, this game might have been good had they put lots of more polish on the gameplay and not just the graphics, but sadly, Sega thought to keep the reason people were complaining about the other games to the graphics or something. But either way, this is still a lot better than the sequel, and it's actually kind of worth a rent or borrow if you're a hardcore Sonic fan who wants a quick multiplayer game with Sonic in it. But let me just tell you, Sega did not learn. Sequels exist. A few years later, on the PS2 and the Wii, Sega made a game called Sonic Riders Zero Gravity. This was based on the same engine, and reused many of the same sets from Sonic Riders, and it had better graphics, but it was worse in other ways. The plot was even cornier. Many of the features that should have been in the last one weren't even in there, and worst of all, the game has crappier gameplay. How bad could it possibly be this time? Well, let's find out. The plot this time is something something about robots, something something, I don't know, something something meteorite, something something guys from last game, I'm not even gonna try to calculate this time, let's just get to the gameplay. The gameplay, like I said, is mostly based off that of the first one. The engine is reused, and so are many of the models and animations. There are some differences, however. For example, the gameplay has been changed. In other words, features have been removed. For example, the boost portion's gone, you cannot go pit stop, the stunt features been neutered, in case you claim ever to walk from the first one, and there are other more frustrating additions or removals to this game. For example, grind rails. You have to have a certain air gear to grind on grind rails, unlike the other ones, where you can just go and grind no matter which one you have, I think so. All in all, you also have to unlock them, which is pretty annoying too. The gravity functions are also pretty annoying, especially when you get slowed down by the game, thinking, oh, you can't go fast, let's do this, let's do this. Due to this, enemies can just pass you right off when you try to make a corner. I mean, the corners were better in the original Riders. I mean, even though the original Riders wasn't that great, this game makes the original Riders look like some old Sega 90s grinding games, and Sega back when they actually knew how to make good games. I'm serious, that's how bad Zero Gravity is. Even if you improve the music and the graphics, the gameplay is still horrible, so what's the point? There are also more random glitches than in the first one, thanks to the gravity system. For example, here's how to die when using gravity. Boom, the meter just ran out right when I was up there. And that is just pathetic. All in all, don't buy this game because it has so many glitches and crap, but one more thing, just to add insult to the injury. This stage is called 90s Boulevard. There's also a similar stage as 80s Boulevard. Both of them feature older Sega references throughout the stages, so this serves to remind you that you could be playing a better game now. Yes, it's nice. Oh, you could just take this game in right here, use this, or trade in for a night. See, I mean, you just see it and you're like, I could be playing a much better game right now. Why am I not playing, this garbage? Why am I playing garbage? I could be playing better games. Oh, look, Sonic and Knuckles right there. Or just every game. Yeah, I could play. What are those games? Says this? Oh, look. Fantasy Zone. That game's probably much better than this game. What other games am I going to see that I should go buy GameStop tomorrow? Oh, Fancy Star, yay, I could be playing Fancy Star right now on my 360. So I should say, like, why is this an 80s Boulevard thing again? Okay, because... Yeah, okay, the sound was in the 80s then. Okay, you think you're being from the 80s. What were these guys smoking? How did they mess the time zone? Just like the other Sonic games in the past, Zero Gravity fixes absolutely nothing either, so all the same problems from the first one are still there. Anyway, don't buy it, they're both garbage, and you will regret the money you spent on these games. All in all, just buy better games. Anyway, thanks for watching, subscribe for more, and please buy better racing games. Support the companies that make better games, and don't buy garbage like this. Please, just stop it.